dogs like human babies? If you answered they both look cute when you carry them in little backpacks, you're right. But there's even more to it than that. We sent Fig O'Reilly on a very cute assignment to learn more.
Dogs are the best. They love us when we're feeling down. They look cute in costumes. And they even save us from natural disasters. But did you know dogs can help teach us how human language works? Just ask Dr. Amritha Mallikarjun, a cognitive scientist at the University of Maryland's Canine Language Lab.
So I was always really interested in learning more about learning language. And as a parallel, I've always just loved dogs. And it wasn't until about 3 years ago that I realized that these interests could combine and I could learn more about language learning through dogs.
Amritha studies how dogs and infants perceive speech and how they're similar to and different from each other. Today, I'll be helping Amritha run a study with some very cute test subjects, like my new friend, Lindsay the Corgi.
So how are dogs and infants alike?
Dogs and infants are a lot alike when it comes to processing speech. Dogs can hear better than infants, but dogs and young infants know roughly the same amount of words.
So what kind of study are we doing today?
Today we're studying the consonant bias. I'm gonna give you an example. If I asked you, what kind of an animal is a monkey? What would you say?
I would think of an animal that swings from trees, has a long tail.
Exactly, we're thinking of a monkey. So even when I change the vowel in the word monkey to monkey, it still remains the same animal. Monkey, monkey.
Mm-hmm.
But if we change the consonant in a word, like monkey to tunkey, then the word becomes unrecognizable.
Consonants are more important to distinguish between words than vowels.
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
So today we're gonna be testing dogs to see if they show a consonant bias like adult humans, or if, like infants, they don't show a consonant bias and instead show a vowel bias.
So we're learning about how dogs communicate and also about how humans communicate.
Yes, that's exactly it.
To run our experiment, we set up this testing station. There are speakers to the left and right, and Amritha sends them audio from her laptop. Every dog is going to have a different test. Some dogs will have a vowel switch in their name. Others will have a consonant switch. And some will hear a completely unrelated name. I'll be recording how the dogs respond and using a ball to refocus their attention to the center of the booth between tests. First up is Ayla. We play Ayla two names, Corby and Kirby, and she's not interested. It's clear that Ayla knows her own name,
Ayla,
but can't be bothered with the vowel switched name, Ula.
Ula. Ula.
Now it's Tag's turn. Tag responds to his own name. And after a quick recentering to the consonant switched name, Bag.
Bag.
Now it's time for Tag's sister, Lindsay.
Yipsy, yipsy, yipsy.
After doing the study on a few more dogs, it's time to figure out what we've learned. Amritha's lab has tested over 700 dogs, so she has plenty of insight, even with today's small sample size.
What do you think? I noticed that when we changed the consonant, they treated it like it was their name, but when we changed the vowel, they couldn't tell and didn't think it was their name, so they just ignored it.
Exactly, so dogs are behaving a lot like 5-month-old infants. They're detecting vowel changes in names, but not consonant changes.
So if I name my dogs something like Timbo and Tambo, as opposed to Bob and Rob, that would be much better for distinguishing the two dogs.
Yes, then your dogs will be able to tell their names apart.
Thank you so much for including me in this. I've learned so much about dogs and humans and how we communicate.
I'm so excited for more people to learn more about cognitive science and all the cool stuff that we're studying. And also, look at what I get to do for my job. I'm cuddling dogs right now.